Bonjour, mes amis. I'm Vernedi, the demon fairy Snail. And welcome to another retro episode. This time, we're reviewing Infinity Inc. Issue 1. Published by DC Comics on March 1984. This comic was the partial inspiration for CW's TV show Stargirl. And it will be the basis for Season 3 of Stargirl, titled Frenemies, which will feature Mr. Bones, Dr. Love, and the residents of the Helix Institute, all taken directly from storylines seen in issues 16, 17, issue 52, and many others of this series, which I might review in the future, if this video gets enough views, that is. If those comics are anything to go by, Dr. Love and Mr. Bones, who are villains, they're going to have a deep connection with Yolanda Montes, aka Wildcat 2. But I digress. The initial cast of this team of young heroes consisted of some characters that are no longer in the public consciousness and who no longer exist, as well as Green Lantern Alan Scott's twin children who become JSA mainstays. And they are Jenny Lynn and Todd Rice. And they are accompanied by Lita Trevor, who was the daughter of Wonder Woman and Steve Trevor. Yes, Wonder Woman at one point had a daughter. Sadly, that ceased to be because of the stupid crisis on Infinite Earths. Oh, another teammate was Hector Hall, aka the Silver Scarab, who was the son of Hawkman and Hawkwoman. We also have the godson of Al Pratt's Adam, named Nuklon. And then we have Hawkman's godson, named Northwind. Hey, doesn't Marvel also have a character named Nuklon? Except in Marvel, instead of being related to the Atom, in Marvel Comics, Nuklon was the son of Whizzer and Miss America. Whizzer was basically Marvel's first speedster, and essentially the World War II equivalent to DC's Flash. That gives me an idea for a fanfiction. Anyhow, must be some overlap or coincidence. These young heroes wanted to join the JSA, but they were rejected by the original team for being too young and inexperienced. However, three members of the JSA ended up quitting the team and joining the young heroes in supporting them. These three heroes are Huntress, who was the daughter of Batman and Catwoman. Yes, Batman and Catwoman had a daughter. But just like with Lita Trevor, she ceased to exist because of the stupid crisis on Infinite Earths. Damn it! Then the other team member that quit was Power Girl, who was the cousin of Superman, and who most of you know as Supergirl. And the third member who quit was Sylvester Pemberton, known to viewers and fans of Stargirl as the original Starman. But in this comic, instead he was known as the Star-Spangled Kid and Skyman, because Starman is a completely different character. Anyhow, Lita Trevor and Hector Hall, who are the children of Wonder Woman and Hawkman respectively, were the characters who fascinated me the most, especially Lita, since, you know, since I, as I mentioned, it was the only time in Wonder Woman's history when Diana's love story with Steve was allowed to flourish and reach its natural conclusion. And fun fact, in post-crisis continuity, Lita Trevor and Hector Hall, they ended up conceiving a child. And, well, actually, before the crisis, Lita found out that she was pregnant with Hector's child. And in post-crisis continuity, the child was born, and the child ended up becoming the second Sandman from Neil Gaiman's famous fantasy comic series. So yes, had the crisis never happened, and had Neil Gaiman's Sandman occur, then Wonder Woman's grandson would have been Daniel Hall, aka the Sandman. How cool is that? I wish the stupid crisis had never happened. It ruined a lot of cool things. I don't like modern Wonder Woman. She's awful. Anyhow. And I also don't like that poor Lita no longer exists in the comics. At least Helena Wayne, aka Huntress, is coming back very soon, thanks to Doomsday Clock issue 12 having Dr. Manhattan predict that Helena would rescue her brother Damian Wayne from becoming a villain. Back to this issue. We basically see the origins of the Infinity Inc. team, with the young newcomers being rejected by the JSA, and then being supported and gaining Huntress, Power Girl, and Starman as members. And meanwhile, the JSA are attacked by Brainwave and the Secret Society of Supervillains. And in future issues, even the Infinity Inc. young heroes believe that the original JSA was killed by the Secret Society of Supervillains. This right there is another thing that CW Stargirl very likely borrowed from. Because in that show, the original JSA died in the very first episode. But gradually we're finding out that some of the members survive. And it's only a matter of time before most of the JSA comes back. On the Stargirl TV show, the Secret Society of Supervillains are instead replaced by the ISA, the Injustice Society of America, who basically are synonymous with the Secret Society of Supervillains, because they even share some of the same members, such as Brainwave. The most notable of them being the Ultra Humanite. The Ultra Humanite was the very first supervillain in history, and was the very first supervillain that Superman ever faced almost 80 years ago, my goodness. Anyhow, I was very satisfied with how much happened in issue 1. They didn't waste any time, like modern comics do nowadays. We even got to see the origins of the new Infinity Inc. members. I always like meeting the children of famous superheroes, and I especially like it when said children adopt new mantles instead of using the ones their parents did, That's why I hate John Kent being Superman, and why I hate Miles Morales being Spider-Man. I would have preferred Miles Morales if he had been a different hero. I don't know, like Spidey or Black Spider-Man. We already have Spider-Man. Spider-Man is Peter Parker. Miles Morales is just an imposter. But I digress. So I prefer when children of superheroes create their own identities instead of taking the mantle of established superhero. In this case, I love that Lita Trevor, instead of becoming Wonder Woman, she became Fury. And Hawkman's son, instead of following the cliche predictable thing, which would have been becoming Hawkboy or something lame like that, he ended up becoming an original hero named Silver Scarab, who was very cool and unique. Silver Scarab was basically like Iron Man in a way, because he had a power suit that gave him his powers, and he could do all sorts of cool things like shooting lasers and flying. So yeah, I very much appreciate that. It keeps more story potential in my opinion. And superhero legacies are fun. That's one reason why I like that Dick Grayson as Robin, when he grew up, instead of becoming Batman right away, he became Nightwing. That was cool. Overall, I love Infinity Inc. issue 1. It is a shame that this book and members such as Wonder Woman's daughter Lita faded into oblivion. That's my main motivation for writing fanfiction and making fan art, to keep these forgotten heroes alive. Speaking of which, after this video, why don't you check out my video that I posted on my second channel, where I painted Lita Trevor. The video is titled Wonder Woman 1984 Redux. As for my final rating, munch it! Thank you for watching. See you next time. Au revoir.